of a lot of security professionals in this room is that, yes, you don't have the voice. So you're basically patching and you're band-aiding things. If collectively, like the group in the room today, you have to start standing up to people to say, if we actually design the network correctly, with segmentation, knowing what's on that actual subnet, knowing that that subnet should never talk to HR, or my PO system should never get updates from this part of the internet, you would cut out a lot of your threat landscape.
So basically, you need to make enough noise to get yourself fired, because yes. You're gonna get fired either way. Flat networks aren't good.
Talk about it, Terrence, come on,
That's true though, you might get fired.
But you'll sleep well at night.
No, but you're going to get fired if the incident happens anyway. So.
And yeah, so you're basically trying to beat the punch. But listen, collectively, we're sounding like a bunch of people who are bullied. And honestly, like, there's some very smart people out there. There's a lot of very good ideas. It's just a lot of people keep them to themselves.
Yeah, and you know, I think you bring up a great point that, you know, when the one of the analogies I like to use is when you build a physical structure, one of the first things you do is you engage an architect. And the architect designs a structure, there's specifications in terms of, you know, what type of electrical wires, what type of framing you have to use. And if you skip that step and you don't use an architect, but you go and build the structure, then the probability of the structure having the right level of integrity goes way down. And so to Terrence's point, you know, having a really solid network architecture, particularly given the fact that organizations are changing fundamentally how they function, becomes